Hello viewers, welcome to the session on residential space design and furnishing. In today's session, we are going to study the topic house ownership and housing finance. In the previous units, we studied the topics house and house planning principles. We also studied furniture and furnishings. In today's session, we will try to understand the meaning of home ownership and housing finance. We will try to acquire knowledge about the types of home finance, gain insight into the importance of housing finance, understand the criteria for securing own home by procedure for seeking home finance. Right. So, let us begin the session with housing status, problems and causes. Along with food and clothes, housing or a shelter is one of the three most important requirements of human being. If the total population of about 1200 million populations is divided by 5, the average number of members in a family, the country requires housing for 240 million families. Of this, 2.4 million, around 30%, are either houseless or houses made of tree and plant, live-in and bamboo and mud houses. Housing in India varies from palaces of erstwhile Maharajas in Rajasthan to modern apartment buildings in big cities to tiny huts in far-flung villages. There has been tremendous growth in India's housing sector as incomes have risen. With modernization, there are a growing number of nuclear families in which each couple occupies its own house after marriage in urban areas. Now, let us look at the status. The affordable housing sector is clearly in need of supply amplification, which would only happen if more institutional funding were to start pouring into this segment. Until recently, most housing developments and therefore fund houses focused on housing for the high to mid-income segment population. This resulted in a significant gap between the demand and supply of affordable homes. However, the prolonged economic slowdown in the country caused this focus to gradually shift to where the real demand exists, namely budget homes. Let us now study the problems involved. The problems of housing are most acute among the lower middle class and the villages. The various housing estates made by private promoter, joint venture and small private contractors are very few compared to the huge population, particularly in rural areas where people require houses but they do not have either finance or the other resources of materials. Owning a house, advantages and disadvantages. Factors influencing the house owning ability. A lot of thinking process is involved while owning a house, as it is the most expensive undertaking involving a major proportion of the family's resources and savings, that is, it could go up to 20% to 30%. The parameters which determine the proportion of families' resources to be spent on the housing are: the first one is family income. Second, the monthly housing allowance. Third, family's cash reserves. Fourth one, future earning power. Methods of owning a house. A house just completed may be purchased from the individual builder or company dealing with the housing operations. An old house may be bought and necessary renovations, modification and extensions may be made later on. A land may be purchased with a view to construct a house in accordance with the needs of the family. Each of the above methods of obtaining a house, however, has its own advantages and disadvantages. Advantages of owning a house. A house provides greater degree of freedom. Ability to design the house as per your wish. Future modification of exteriors as per the latest trends and wishes. More privacy with no more problems with regard to sound sweepage. One can expand the space as per requirement in the future when your children grow up. One can develop the higher floors when you want to make some additional income through rent. These are advantages. Now let us look at the disadvantages. Houses require constant upkeep and attention. Repair people are not always available and they are usually expensive, making at least some to do it yourself skills essential for most homeowners. It usually costs more to own than to rent, if all costs of home ownership are accurately computed. The struggle to meet costs of home ownership may rob certain members of other developmental opportunities. Ownership ties a family to a given location because property often cannot be sold without a sacrifice. The family should enjoy the cares and responsibilities of home ownership. Property values may decline and investment in a house decrease accordingly. In times of economic stress and reduced income, the family may find itself encumbered with ownership costs out of relation to its income. Let us now study government and private housing schemes for home ownership. The Government of India has been taking all necessary steps to meet the shortage of rural housing for quite some time. The earliest known initiative was for rehabilitation of refugees immediately after the partition of the country. After that, there were other initiatives in the area of rural housing. However, rural housing initiatives in its true sense and vigor in India began with the Indira Awas Yojana, IAY, which was launched as a sub-scheme of RLEGP in 1985-86. From April 1989, it became a sub-scheme of the Jawahar Rojgar Yojana, JRY. Since 1996, however, it was delinked from JRY and made an independent scheme. Rural housing schemes. The government is implementing Ashraya Dr. Ambedkar and Indira Awas Yojana only in rural areas, housing schemes, for the economically weaker section in rural and urban areas of the state. Jilla Panchayat is implementing this scheme in rural areas. With a view to meeting the housing needs of the rural poor, Indira Awas Yojana, IAY, was launched in May 1985 as a sub-scheme of Jawahar Rojgar Yojana. It is implemented as an independent scheme since 1 January 1996. Benefits of Yojana are extended to widows or next of kin of defense personnel killed in action. Also to ex-servicemen and retired members of the parliamentary forces as long as they fulfill the normal eligibility conditions of Indira Awas Yojana. Dr. Ambedkar Housing Scheme. The scheme is aimed to provide a house to a houseless SC or ST person whose annual income is less than 11,800. The unit cost of a house is 20,000. The whole scheme is on subsidy pattern. This scheme is being implemented by the Rajiv Gandhi Rural Housing Corporation Limited, RGR HCL from 2000 to 2001. Ashraya Yojana. This scheme will provide house to houseless persons whose annual income is less than 11,800. The beneficiaries are selected in the Gram Sabha. The unit cost of a house is 20,000, which is met out by Rajiv Gandhi Rural Housing Corporation Limited. Credit cum subsidy scheme, CCSS. This scheme for rural housing was launched with effect from 1/4/1999, targeting rural families having annual income up to 32,000 rupees. While subsidy is restricted to 10,000, the maximum loan amount that can be availed is 40,000 rupees. The subsidy portion is shared by the center and the state in 75:25 ratio. The loan portion is to be disbursed by the commercial banks, housing finance institutions, etc. From the year 2002 to 2003, the central allocation under IAY CCSS has been combined. 20% of the IAY funds earmarked for upgradation could be utilized for implementation of the scheme. Government also implements innovative stream of schemes for rural housing and habitat development to encourage the use of cost-effective, environment-friendly, scientifically tested and proven indigenous and modern designs, technologies and materials, a scheme called Innovative Stream for Rural Housing and Habitat Development, which was launched on 1st April 1999. The Rural Building Center Movement, popularly known as the Nirmiti Movement, was started in 1985 in Kerala with a view to promote technology transfer, information dissemination, skill upgradation through training and production of cost-effective and environment-friendly building components. Government designs housing scheme for urban poor. With a view to solve the problem of housing for economically weaker section and lower income group families in urban areas, the Ministry of Housing and Urban Poverty Alleviation, Government of India, has designed an interest subsidy scheme under the Jawaharlal Nehru Urban Renewal Mission. The scheme aims at providing home loans with central government subsidy of 5% through primary lending institutions. Beneficiaries who own land in any urban areas but do not have any pakka house in their name or in the name of their spouse or any dependent will also be covered under the scheme. The scheme will also provide a subsidized loan for 15 to 20 years for a maximum amount of 1 lakh rupees for an economically weaker section individual. For lower income group individual, the maximum loan amount will be 16,000 rupees. The nodal agencies for the scheme will be the National Housing Bank and HUDCO, that is HUDCO, which will provide the benefit through banks or housing finance companies. Government housing scheme also for middle income groups. Another scheme called affordable housing has been launched. Under this new scheme, another 10 lakh, 1 million houses are targeted, not only covering economically weaker section, but also MIG, middle income group. To provide housing to the urban poor, the ministry recently launched an interest subsidy scheme. Under this scheme, the urban poor will be able to get housing loans from banks and institutions at an interest rate of 5% lower than the market rate. Housing finance definition and importance. Housing finance definition. Housing has been primarily a self-help activity. State intervention is necessary to meet the housing requirements of the vulnerable sections and to create an enabling environment in accomplishing the goals of shelter for all in a self-sustainable basis. India has been constantly working to provide shelter to its population. For sustainable development of the society, housing demand is assessed and suitable mechanisms are evolved for meeting the demand. According to Wallace F. Smith, housing finance is a factor of production quite distinct from labor materials and risk taking. In housing sector, finance serves the following vital purposes. Finance is needed for purchase and development of house sites, purchase of building materials and actual building a house, meeting the annual charges consisting of the upkeep and maintenance, including rehabilitation of kaccha houses, taxes, interest and amortization charges on capital, and covering risks involved in long-term housing investment. Importance of housing finance. The fact is that housing is a very expensive commodity which needs heavy capital outlay. Testifies to the vital role of finance in housing sector. In fact, housing leans heavily on finance, which makes housing function of finance to considerable extent. Land in this country is more valuable than most other commodities, and therefore purchase and development of house sites involve a substantial amount of finance. Similarly, actual building of a house is quite expensive because it involves purchase of costly building materials and labor. Let us now study the problems of housing finance. What are the problems encountered? Housing finance has a long-term character. Housing requires special kind of finance, mostly and preferably long-term finance, for more than one reason. The product involved is not readily saleable and does not yield monetary return as in agriculture or industry. In addition, personal savings or contribution can cover only a small fraction of the total cost of housing, and the balance has to be necessarily covered by long-term credit. Mortgage orientation. Mortgage finance is the lifeblood of housing finance. Housing is the most costly commodity, and hence it needs a huge capital investment in the initial stage itself. This initial capital expenditure will be much more than the lifetime earnings of most of the families. Imbalance between its supply and need. The problem of housing finance emanates from the limitations of means compared to huge investment needs of housing. Always financial needs of housing fall short of the provision of finance. This universal phenomenon of housing finance is the probable reason for the World Bank to maintain a feeling that housing is a bottomless pit. This imbalanced condition of housing finance is prevalent both in affluent and poor countries. And this is worse when we talk of poor and underdeveloped countries. Housing finance is not as self-liquidating as agricultural finance or industrial finance. This peculiar feature poses a big problem in housing finance. An investor, either in agriculture or in industry, can look for a further income stream as the source of repayment. That is to say, agricultural or industrial investment usually yields quick return, but housing investment is not so. House after the completion can be rented out, which will start yielding a return, but this will be a very insignificant amount in relation to the huge investment, and also will come month by month very slowly and leisurely. That is why the lenders are reluctant to lend to house builders. Therefore, while in agriculture or in industry, interest forms only a small proportion to total annual cost. In the case of housing, it is the largest recurring cost factor. Hence, housing finance is much more sensitive to the level of interest rates than agricultural and industrial finance. Sources of housing finance. Housing industry consists of formal or organized and informal or unorganized sector. Organized sector is operated by the apex body National Housing Bank, NHB, a subsidiary of RBI. The beginning of formal housing finance in India first came with the setting up of HUDCO in 1971. HUDCO sought mainly to cater to lower income groups, but at the same time provided technical and finance assistance to state housing boards, urban development institutions, and to the cooperative sector. Private sector involvement in retail housing finance did not begin until the setting up of Housing Development Finance Corporation Limited, which is in short known as HDFC, in 1977. HDFC specialized in providing housing finance to individuals, cooperative societies, and the corporate sector. HDFC's initial share capital included subscription from His Royal Highness the Aga Khan and International Finance Corporation, Washington, IFC. The major financial institutions which finance housing sector may be classified into two broad groups depending upon whether housing finance is there. First one is primary function, specialized housing finance institutions like HDFC, LIC, HFL, etc. Second one is a secondary function, non-specialized housing finance institutions like commercial banks. Specialized housing finance institutions. HUDCO, the Housing and Urban Development Corporation. Specialized housing finance institutions have been set up with the sole purpose of financing house construction purchasing activities. HUDCO was established on 25th April 1970 as a wholly owned subsidiary and government-owned enterprise with a view to ameliorate the housing conditions in the urban and rural areas of the country, build new satellite towns, finance building material industries, undertake consultancy in the areas of housing and urban development, conduct research in low cost and assist various agencies dealing with housing and urban development in a positive manner. HDFC, Housing Development and Finance Corporation Limited. Housing Development Finance Corporation was started in 1977 as a private sector institution to make long-term housing loans. It acts as a mortgage bank, that is, it raises long-term funds from institutional sources and lends these to home buyers. HDFC follows a variable rate of interest policy, but unlike HUDCO lending terms, HDFC's policy of variable interest rate is based borrower. HDFC also receives assistance from USAID and Aga Khan Foundation for housing finance activities. NHB, National Housing Bank. The NHB, established by Act of Parliament 1987 as an apex housing finance institution, started functioning from July 9, 1988. The bank is wholly owned by the RBI, Reserve Bank of India. The NHB at present has a capital of 450 crores, fully paid up by the RBI. NHB is responsible inter alia for the development of housing finance system on sound lines. The NHB is empowered under the provision of the NHB Act 1987 in public interest by general special order to regulate, prohibit issue of advertisement to solicit deposits from public by HFCs. It can also specify the conditions subject to which such advertisement is issued. In public interest, direction can be given as receipt of deposits and so on. LIC HFL, LIC Housing Finance Limited. LIC Housing Finance Limited was incorporated in 19 July 1989 by the LIC along with ICICI, UTI and IFCI as co-promoters with authorized capital of ₹100 crores and paid up capital of 75 crores with number of initial employees 649 and with the 67 operating offices along with 100 extension counters, camp offices, 6 regional offices and the corporate office at Mumbai. It subsequently went public in September 1994 at a premium of ₹50 per share. Presently, the company is the largest housing finance company in terms of market shares, next only to HDFC. Well, to conclude the session, a decent place for living is the third most basic need of a person after the needs of food and clothing. Owning a house ensures certain degree of economic as well as social security to a citizen. It also determines the intellectual growth and has a bearing on the overall development of a nation. Providing a just sufficient shelter remains one of the most serious challenges India is facing today. The problem of inadequate housing is more acute in the rural areas where bulk of the below poverty line population lives. In this perspective, housing thrust is most appropriately directed towards social housing to reach out housing solutions to the priority groups is a priority which the governments are trying to adequately address. An equally important activity is to maintain a policy framework and a legislative, fiscal and financial system that would put into effect the enabling role of the government in stimulating, supporting and promoting other actors to play direct roles in the housing delivery. Well, viewers, I hope you have been benefited by the session on housing finance. Thank you for watching.